Hi friends, in this video we are going to know about the periodic table, the modern periodic table, groups of elements and their properties. Let us see in detail. Look here, this is the modern periodic table. Do you know who proposed it? Moseley proposed this periodic table. It is also called as long form of periodic table. It shows all the elements that makes up everything. There are 118 elements. Look here. This is the modern periodic table. There are some rows and columns. And columns are called as groups. There are 18 groups. And the horizontal rows are called as periods. There are 7 periods. 18 groups and 7 periods. And the group 1, that means hydrogen to francium. The number of electrons in the outermost shell is 1. So, their valency is 1. And the valency of group 2 is 2. Because they are having 2 electrons in the outermost shell. So, they lost 2 electrons to gain stability. And in the middle, they are called D block elements. Later, we will discuss about it. Now, group 13. The elements of group 13 are having 3 electrons in the outermost shell. So, they are ready to lose 3 electrons. That's why valency is 3. And next, group 14. They are having 4 electrons in the outermost shell. They may lose or gain 4 electrons. So, valency is 4. And group 15. In these elements, there are 5 electrons in the outermost shell. So, they require 3 electrons to gain stability. So, valency is 3. And group 16, they are having 6 electrons in the outermost shell. And they require 2 electrons to get stability. So, valency is 2. And group 17, they are having 1 electron in the outermost shell. So, the valency is 1. And now, group 18. These elements are also called as zero group elements, also inert gases. They are having 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So, there is no need of electrons. That's why valency is 0. Now, let us see all the categories in detail. Category 1. They are alkali metals. They belongs to group 1. Except hydrogen, all are metals. Hydrogen is non-metal. Here, lithium to francium, they are shiny, soft enough to cut with knife. They are having 1 valence electron, makes it very reactive, not found alone in nature, burst into flame or explode with water. They are usually stored in oils. Next one, category 2, they are alkaline earth metals. They belongs to group 2. They are having two electrons in the outermost shell. So their valence is 2, and they are very reactive, but less than alkali metals. They rarely found alone in nature, and the uses of these alkali earth metals. Beryllium is used in X-ray. Beryllium is used for construction. X-ray can pass through it. Calcium is used in plaster, cement, drywall, and etc. Radium is a radioactive element and used to treat different cancers. In this way, alkali earth metals are used. Next, category 3. They are lanthanides. These lanthanides are given separately below the periodic table because too many elements to fit vertically, so it is flipped horizontally. They are silvery white color when freshly cut. They tarnish in air. All the elements ignite at high temperatures. They are also radioactive elements. They used for ceramics and metallurgy, and also some elements are used in nuclear reactions. Next, category 4. They are actinides. These are also given below the periodic table. All are radioactive elements. They occur naturally on Earth in great amounts. They are solid at room temperature. When in boiling water or acid, produces gas. Here, californium used in smoke detectors. Uranium is used in nuclear reactors and also used to measure how old the Earth is. These are all radioactive elements. They belong to 7th period. Next, category 5. These are all transition metals. They belong to D block. And these are from group 3 to group 12. And they are all hard but malleable. They are also shiny. All the transition metals are good conductors of electricity. For example, gold, silver, iron, platinum, copper, and so on are good conductors of electricity. That's why they are used in wiring and conducting electricity. Next, category 6. These are all called as post-transition metals, also called as poor metals. These are all poor metals. They still conduct electricity but less than transition metals. They are softer in touch, so easily malleable. For example, aluminium, number 13th element. The uses of these poor metals: aluminium is used to make vessels. They are all used for plating steel because it is easily malleable. That means it is easy to bend. Next, category 7. They are called metalloids, also poor metals. Look here, they are in green color. They are shown in green color. These are in between metals and non-metals. They are also called as semiconductors. That means they conduct electricity at high temperature but insulates at low temperatures. These are all used in electronics. That means for making parts and components in all electronics. They are also used in protective material such as bulletproof jackets and magnets. And Next one, eighth category. Those are all non-metals. Look here, they are shown in blue color. Here, including hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur, etc. are non-metals. And we can say they are the building blocks of living things. Without these non-metals, we cannot survive. Carbon builds all living things. Nitrogen and phosphorus essential for soil nutrients. Oxygen for all energy productions. So, they are very very important. And also, they are P-block elements. Next category, that is ninth category. Here, they are shown in pink color. They are called halogens. That is group 17. And also called as fluorine family. Here, they are having 7 valence electrons. They need only 1 electron. So, they are very chemically reactive. They combine with alkali metals to make salts. Because they are very reactive, so fluorine is used in tooth cleaning and chlorine is used for cleaning products to kill bacteria. Their valence is 1. And the next category is 10th one, that is noble gases. Look here, group 18 elements are called as noble gases and they are also called as inert gases. They are noble, that means does not like to associate with others. They are having 8 valence electrons, that means the outermost shell is filled with 8 electrons. They do not bond with others. They are colorless, odorless, and also non-reactive elements. These elements are used in welding and also common light bulbs such as helium. Helium is used in light bulbs. Neon is used in neon signboards. Helium and krypton are used in photography. In this way, they are used. In the long form of periodic table, there are 18 groups and 7 periods. And the last elements, that is 113 to 118, they are newly discovered elements. The properties of these are not clearly known till today. Thank you.